respected faculty members, panel members, and student managers. My name is Athira.
Good evening, everyone. This is Anjali Singh.
And we are from River Alaknanda. So before I proceed to the topic, I'm pretty sure that most of us are nostalgic about our school days. So, you know, one of those fascinating aspects that we are fond of our school days are stationery. So, Camlin is one of those brands which you know, brings back all the memories and nostalgic moments. So, here I proceed to my topic, which is the rise of KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd.
Yeah, Camlin. Camlin is a well-known, tremendous brand which touched the lives of us, and be a pen, pencil, and the oil colors and watercolors. From there, for all of these, we enjoy during their, you know, school days. So Camlin is a brand which touched the lives of most of the Indians. These are the contents: introduction, history and heritage of KOKUYO CAMLIN, segmentation of KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd, product portfolio, innovative products, strategies adopted, competitors, financials, and then finally conclusion.
So to start off with introduction, initially CAMLIN was known as Dandekar & Company in 1931. It was founded by D.P. Dandekar, and then it started manufacturing horse brand ink powders, and later on it changed to Camel Ink, and it was named as CAMLIN. So CAMLIN is derived as a combination of camel and ink, so that's how the name has arrived to CAMLIN. And the headquarters is situated in Mumbai. And in May 2011, KOKUYO, which is a Japanese company, one of the most oldest stationery company, it acquired 51% of stake in CAMLIN Ltd. And the chairman of KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd of India is Mr. Subhash Dandekar.
So here the history and heritage of CAMLIN Ltd, KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd. This slide shows how much CAMLIN contributed towards the Indian stationery market. Starting in 1931, they started their horse brand ink powders and tablets. In 1942, Dandekar and Company renamed as CAMLIN Private Ltd, combined with Camel and Ink, so it converted into CAMLIN Private Ltd. 1962, entering into art material, they provide the colors, watercolors, and oil petals, and brushes, and pencils. In 1974, wooden pencils were introduced for the first time in India, which were introduced by CAMLIN. And 1982, first All India Camel Color Contest were organized, and it was the first time that any kind of contest was organized in India. 1987, CAMLIN was recognized as a public limited company. 1998, ICCC All India Camel Color Contest was the most popular child artist contest in that year. It has 30 lakh children which participated in that contest. 2005, a new plastic body market range were introduced in India, which is also by the CAMLIN. And 2011, KOKUYO became the parent company of CAMLIN, and it's converted into KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd.
So, segmentation of KOKUYO CAMLIN Ltd. So, on the basis, it's based on two categories. One is segmentation by use and segmentation by type. Segmentation by use is basically the office use and the school use, which comes under the major contribution of the products of CAMLIN. And this under segmentation by type, there comes notebooks and paper, then computer and daily use, writing instruments. In the following slides, I'll be explaining about the product portfolio. So the product segmentation is categorized into three. One is the school and education products, fine arts and hobby materials, then office and stationery and products. So notebooks, drawing books, pencil, pens, I mean, this particular section is the most contributing sector for CAMLIN. And fine arts and hobby materials comes under the second larger contribution for under the Camlin product category, and followed by office stationery and products.
Innovative products. Here's the asset of Camlin Limited: innovation. He always believe in innovation rather than the approaching towards mass media promotions. It believes that they would promote, they would invest more in like the development or in the quality maintaining products. So there's a very good R&D department of Camlin. So here are the innovative products which were launched by Camlin. They are brush pens. Brush pens are used as a, like in fine arts. They are the watercolor which fill in brush pens and which give us comfort as we can use it as like a pen. And square glue sticks. Square glue sticks is the ready-made sticks which can be, there's some kind of pen which we put in the glue sticks, put in that pen, and we use it like as a pen also. Washable crayons. Washable crayons is like much before the child handed over with the pen or like pencils, they have like the crayons. So wall is like the canvas for the children. So there is a much major concern about the mess or untidiness for crayons. So they launched washable crayons which can easily washable and which also gives more innovative which give more innovative thought. And Camlin Nova automatic mechanical pen, it is like the mechanical pen which you just click once and you just kept writing for a while. You don't need to be like clicking more one and more times in shorter period. And cover IT slim correction pen is which we call like, we all of us call like whitener. And they are a metal tip, they have a metal tip and which we, you know, apply the white ink which hide the spots and all. And Nova gripper wooden pencils are the wooden pencils which have like the grip around towards around all of it.
Now comes the strategy. There's like marketing strategy, promotional strategy, and distribution. So marketing strategy, it's the first is the tie-up with the schools. Like during the admission, you know, the school kids, they're provided with the Camlin stationery kits. Then tie-up with different brands. This is nothing but, you know, the most, the segment that's mostly concentrated is the kids section, I mean the kids who are attracted to the stationery. So, you know, through different cartoon characters, for example, in the international brand like the Pokemon or the Justice League characters, they are printed on the packaging of Camlin products. And then comes the promotional strategy. They organize All India Color Contest. They also organize art exhibition, which is Camlin Foundation, which was established in 1997. This is to promote the growth and the culture. And then there's art teacher workshops, hobby workshop, craft workshop. So this literally involves the child's skills as well. Now distribution, it reaches to more than 1 lakh retail outlets. It has tie-up with Zebra, which is another Japanese company, which is tied up with, I mean, Zebra is mostly known for the ball pens that they've used. And then e-commerce, they promote through various online sites.
Competitors of Camlin Limited are Hindustan Pencils, which are already concentrated towards pencils. Classmates are only, notebooks of classmates are the major competitor for Camlin. And Faber Castell is for the colors, which are major competitor for Camlin. Doms pencils are also the major competitors. And the Archie is the stationary gifts of the competitors. They are the biggest one competitors for Camlin.
So now talking about the revenue, we can see from 2014, in 2014 it was 568 and there is a gradual increase, but in 2017 to 18, there is a slight decrease, like major reasons being inflation, GST and demonetization, those being the primary reasons.
So here is the conclusion, here is the excellent R&D.